Good morning, everybody. Morning. All you beautiful young people. And I'm allowed to say that. If I say the year I was born in now, it's going to be captured there forever. But it's okay. It's a number I'll own. I was born in 1975. So I can see your young beauty, and I honor you for that. Because remember, you are beautiful. You are attractive. You are a person full of courage. You are called by God. You are made in His image. You are anointed. And did you know you are no longer a slave like Romans says, but you are a child of God. We are sons and daughters, heirs, which means we inherit everything in the kingdom of God. You and me, ma'am. You and me, sir. We inherit everything, but only if we believe it, right? We have to believe it. We don't believe the lies and the voices of the world as you heard in the workshops. We have to tell ourselves daily, I'm a son and a daughter of God. So I greet you as a blessed son and daughter of God and know that you are well loved. We know things are tough, but it's okay. God made us strong because He's strong. Amen? Amen. So welcome in this venue. Kerk in Sight here in Centurion. We thank them for sharing this venue with us today. We are so grateful. It's part of community. They open the doors and say, welcome community. So welcome. It happens to be my church, by the way, but they are gracious and they extend their blessing towards us and we're grateful for that. So just a few house rules this morning. I see you already in your beautiful gowns for the ceremony. I know that there are 10 gowns. Ladies and gents, you are going to proceed from your left across the stage. You're going to receive your certificate here from our facilitators. I'm sure you know them so well, but we will mention their names in due course. You are going to exit on my left. You're going to go out. You can walk around again and come back. And then please give the gowns to the next delegates. Is that good? Okay. You don't have to run, okay? But don't take too long, okay? Safety first. Okay. Then the bathrooms outside. Again, it's my left, but you can walk along the back there. You'll see, you'll pass the kitchen, and then it's the ladies' and the gents' bathroom there as well. Okay. And any other house rules? Cleo, Gladys, Mampu? Cell phones. Thank you, ma'am. So please just put your cell phone on silent, okay? And or airplane mode or do not disturb. If you're expecting a call, then just tell them you'll talk to them this afternoon. Oh, yes. And then I need to look at the camera as well as our entertainment and other speakers. We are recording this for you so that you can look back at this day. You can go back to the link and you can share it with your family. And you can have this live stream as will be available as well. Thank you to the church as well. And thank you. God works out things for the good. Because, yes, it was COVID, but it enabled all of these platforms. Before that, we didn't use it. So now it's available. Super. Any other house rules? Sorted. We good. There will be refreshments afterwards. If you feel you're going to pass out, then come to one of us for a glass of water or a sip of cold drink, okay? We don't want your blood sugar to drop. Just shout, okay? Or smile and wave, okay? So you're so welcome. And I'm going to ask our chairman from Ukalunga Foundation, Wally, to come and open for us in prayer this morning. Yes, shouts of cheer are welcome. Thank you, Wally.
Thank you very much, Rialet. It's an absolute pleasure to be with you this morning. Wonderful to see all the faces. You look very smart. Compliments. Good hand of applause to yourself for making the effort that you have been making. So well done and congratulations and very welcome here at our church. It's wonderful for us to share some moments here. I hope this is not the last time we see your friendly face with us here in this church. You'll be welcome to join us here as well. So we are together to celebrate a special day. We are saying grace and thank you to everybody who has worked so hard. Special hand for our ladies who've been working with you on this program. We are delighted that they are with us. There are others who worked hard behind the scenes to make it possible. And all of this is thanks to the grace of God. And we are so blessed and we are so happy that this could happen. And we are extremely pleased with you to share this day together. So let us bow our heads and say thank you to the Lord for this. Lord, thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity. Thank you that we can come together and that we can celebrate, Lord, all in your name and in your glory. Thank you for extending us this opportunity, both to participate and to present. It is a blessing for all of us, for which we are very grateful. We ask, Lord, that you bless the gathering of today, all the activities that will happen. But Lord, we also ask you to be with us in the road going forward. You know that things have not been easy for most of us. Lord, it's time for a new dawn. And we know that that dawn is possible in your name. We know with your grace and with the power we receive through you that we can stand and that we will have victory. All in your name and in your glory. Bless us today during this event. And I ask that you also bless the organizers. And thank you for everyone who has contributed to make a success of this day. In your holy name, amen. I think we are now going to stand and we are going to sing the national anthem. So please join us for that.
Thank you. I declare this event open. You may sit, ladies and gentlemen. Psalm 126, verse 1 to 3 says, "When the Lord brought back the captives to Zion, we were like men and women who dreamed. Our mouths were filled with laughter. our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. I have a dream. It was 28 August 1963. So 28 August was just this week that Martin Luther King delivered his speech at the Lincoln Memorial. And this is a quote from his speech. I have a dream. Guys, he put it out there. He declared, I have a dream. And his dream was so big. He announced and put it out into the world and proclaimed to the world he has a dream. His dream was so big, it was not just for himself. It's for a nation. It's not a daydream. It's still for a nation. Do you agree? Yes. So I hope today, young man, young lady, woman, man of God, woman of God, I hope today that you know Jesus as your dream giver. I believe you attended this workshop with a dream, right? Yes. A hope. I hope, and it's a prayer that throughout your journey, you will regularly, daily speak to Jesus and ask him to guide you through your dream. I'm reading my speech because I wrote it from my heart, so I hope you don't mind, okay? So as Ukulunga Foundation, that's who I represent, and Wally and Tess and some of the people that you see working here today, we sponsored the workshops. So it is our dream to make a difference and to help someone, you, someone in your family, to be better, even if it is only for one. We partnered with IOC, Gladys and Cleo, and with ODA, Mampu, Ingrid is not here today, and everybody that I'm not mentioning, apologies. But thank you to the ODA and IOC. We will get to the thanks, but we partnered with them. And we have such brilliant facilitators, right? Cleo and Gladys, Mampu, you guys, you are amazing. And they're so equipped at guiding you, young women and men, on this journey. So thank you as well to the ODA for getting all the delegates and for making space to make this happen. Thank you. We did set out with big dreams as Ukulunga Foundation, and we still dream big, okay? Dreams may take time. Like, look at Martin Luther King. It's still busy happening, right? Some things happen in an instant. Most things take time. So we not only dreamed, but we actually made something happen, and that's why we're celebrating you today, because this happened. And for us, it's significant, and we hope that you also realize it's significant. Every part in it, every little part or big part that you play in it is significant. So we thank ODA and IOC for making the workshops happen, and we thank our sponsors, and especially our chairman, Mr. Wally, who opened for us in prayer. Guys, he's relentless at generating funds, that man. So thank you, Wally, for the funds and the sponsors that you find for us to make things like this happen. Because that's not my gift, it's his gift. We know our gifts, right? But we work together to be stronger and to make things happen. So with that, it's not in my speech, but look at each other. Don't forget each other. Because community, this is how we get further. Okay? Even if you don't speak to each other and see each other every day, but you and I, we need each other. So tell the guy, the girl next to you, I need you. That's it. So we know that life can be tough, right? Hard and sometimes impossible, right? We know that one workshop might not be the answer. It might not be enough. But we do hope that a workshop equipped you in some small way to think differently, to stop and pause, and to act differently, and to be the difference wherever you live and move. Remember, you cannot solve everything for everyone, okay? But you can make a difference for one person, in one situation, in one moment, okay? So we encourage you today, young man, young lady, young and old, okay? To never stop dreaming, never give up on your dreams. You might dream, but you don't believe it's going to happen. So don't give up on your dreams, okay? We say to you, believe in yourself. We have hope for you. Do you believe me? I have hope for you. Each one of you. Each one of you. Each one of you. It hasn't stopped, no matter how old or young you are. I believe in you, and I have hope for you, because God does, because He says He does. That's why I can say it with confidence to you. So, circumstances might be tough, but rise above it. You have a choice. Let's rise above it. Go and do what you were made to do. We wish you all the best for your future. It starts now. Okay. Thank you. With that, I would like to ask Betty. She's going to bless us with her beautiful voice, and we're going to do two songs for you. Thank you, Betty. Amen. Thank you so much, Betty, and thank you, guys and girls, for sharing that with us. So before I hand over to IOC, I would like to invite ODA. Just checking, dearest Mampu, if you guys, you are welcome. This is your opportunity if you want to say something and tell us maybe where this came from. So...
Good morning, everyone. Can you please give yourself a round of applause? You look beautiful. The ODA way. The ODA way, ne? I don't know where to start. From the beginning, or must I start from the end? So let me start from the beginning, ne? Okay. For those who don't know me, my name is Ginna Usmambu. I don't know, this is a very emotional day for us, ne? So I don't know, can you please stand up because of today, ne? It was the day that Mr. Maja was killed. So at least if, can please observe a moment of silence, please. It's very a very emotional day for us. It has been a very short, long journey. Ne? Okay, let me start to thank the Ugulunga Foundation, the Initiative of Change, for bringing this program to us. I must admit that when we started with the program, we didn't know that it's going to be so successful. As much as 18 people today, they didn't come after they have confirmed, but I just want to applaud the people that came today and also for finishing the program, because I knew when we started introducing the program to you, you said, we don't want to talk about our problems. Remember, most of you didn't want to go and attend the program, but after the first day, most of you wanted to come to the second day. And then there's something that I want to share with you today. I think during the week when we met in preparation, Sorry, you're not used to the cameras, guys, ne? So I might off-ramp, ne? So during the week that we're preparing for this ceremony, I think Bidumelo shared something with us that I saw. I knew that it always made a difference. But after Bidumelo stood up and shared with us what the change that it has done to him, and also we have seen, but from him telling us that, you know, when the time that he started to attend the program, and then also we knew him, the background, you know, we felt that, wow, it's really a change. So I want to applaud you guys that don't start, hi, stop your phone, please. Now, I want to applaud you guys that what you're doing, ne? wow, it's showing. It's not only showing, you know, we don't want people to come and receive the certificate without implementing whatever that you taught them, ne? And also you guys, ne? We don't want you today to come and receive the certificate just for the sake of receiving the certificate. You know, whatever that you were taught, whatever that you were asked to do, can you please go implement it? I know it's still a long journey for you to go, ne? Healing is not a one-day thing, it's a process. So each and every day that you feel that you need to talk to people, Cleo and Gladys are there every time that you want to talk to. And also it's for you to go and testify and give testimony of what are the changes that you've seen after you attended the program. The changes that you're going to see is for you to refer people to come and attend the program. If you refer people to Tapelo, then I know that you'll be healed per se. Ne? Rita, if I see you referring, if I see you referring people, then I know that the inner healing, it has worked. You understand, guys? So today it's your day. Today is not about OTA for me. You know me, I can talk until, ne? So today I don't want to talk. I just want you to enjoy the day, ne? And this is your day. But that's I want to say, halala OTA, halala. Halala Ogulunga, halala. Halala Initiative of Change, halala. Yeah, it's not make sure.
So I'll take over from what the MC was meant to do. Can you hear me? So as it's being said, today it's an emotional day, because how often do we just pause to celebrate what we have achieved? And today, that's what we're saying. We are pausing because we want to know what we have achieved. And I'm going to speak on behalf of Initiatives of Change. Thank you, Kulunga, for saying you've been investing this because you're seeing the hope, even for those who are feeling hopeless. Thank you, ODA, for saying whenever and whatever we can create space for the development of a young person, we will do. And those are the streams that we've had. And as Initiatives of Change, we said, our main call and purpose is for us to build peace and trust however best we can. And the story of South Africa is so unique that the wars, the crime, everything that we hear every day, we know it doesn't happen because people don't know what they're doing. They know what they're doing. But the challenge is, we have inherited so much trauma that we have forgotten how to be human enough to the next person. And that became a call for us as Initiatives of Change to say, what are we doing about the trauma? And with that, what are we doing it to the communities that cannot access it because it's a very expensive thing to invest in? And that journey became of the partnership we're having. And I think as we've been taking as the partners, the three main partners, we do not exist without you guys. And do please applaud yourself, because we're able to talk about the success of the partnership because you've been there. This is our third year doing this together in Olieven. So we're talking of over 200 people who've actually been on the journey of inner healing. And if there's anything I would leave on this earth is to say, when I look back in the community of Olievenhoutbosch alone, what change will you have done because you have found your new purpose? And that's what I would love to see. So the main talk for me is that I wanted to give you a great takeaway. We've had a lot of time, and I was told not to bring my handbag, which is a box of tissues and a candle. Or should I have brought that? So I was warned, do not bring your handbag. And I said, that's okay. So as we're parting the formal training we're doing together, I will leave you with a talk, which I've titled, Your Strength is Your Self-Acceptance. We often consider strength as something strong, but in the journey of healing, strength is only what happens when you're becoming vulnerable with yourself. And that, a lot of people consider it to be a weakness. But in the journey of healing again, weakness is when one person decides to be comfortable with their coping trauma to live their day-to-day life. And I guess we're sitting to say we understand differently who and what we're supposed to be. So today, I want you to stand up, give yourself a hug, and say, I'm celebrating the strength I never knew I have. So if you could do that to yourself. So together, I'm celebrating the strength I never knew I have. Thank you. I thought I should tap a little bit into what trauma is. And I found an interesting description about it to say, trauma, it is what's happening inside of me as a result of what's happening around me. And the good news about trauma is, if trauma was what is happening to me, for example, depression, PTSD, anxiety, rape, abandonment, depression, if that was trauma, then we wouldn't heal. But if you understand that trauma, it is what's happening inside, it's the wound that experience has left in me, then I have a chance to heal. Because you can heal a wound, but you cannot change the experiences. You cannot change that there's war. We cannot change that there are absent fathers. But I can change the pain that does to me, and that's the power you have. This journey for me, I'll share because you know part of me, some of you. It's been interesting. We've had 4 groups this year, which are today celebrating. The first workshop was hard because you made me see another element of my wound, which I've never worked on, and that is the abandonment of particularly my paternal family and my mother. And with the second group, you've made me realize how the beauty of friendship looks like. That group was the most exciting one because every day, the friendship of all those 5 days, it would be what becomes what one wakes up for. With the third group, you gave me a reason because you were the hardest group that one had to give so much of to. But you also became those rough diamonds that at the end, we were like, yeah, not only, that one, yeah, not only, like. And the fourth group, you gave us, the facilitators, and yourself the confidence in knowing that I am the best. And for that, thank you so much. It's been a journey to have from April till now. I said my talk is about self-acceptance. And self-acceptance has been the key goal to what self-love and self-trust. We've had conversation when we're asking, how do I love when I don't know what love is? How do I trust when I've never known how to trust someone? But the journey we've been on is to say, I cannot expect to have that from an outside if I've not received that within me and given it to me. Self-acceptance is about not comparing yourself with anyone, but comparing yourself with yourself. Meaning, my tomorrow should be better than my today. Self-acceptance says to you every day, don't stop showing up for yourself, because your talents and your purpose in this world cannot be diminished unless you want it to be diminished. On self-acceptance, I have a newly found, or maybe amplified, actor, Viola Davis. Maybe some of you know. She's one of the key actresses on the Woman King movie. And she says, I no longer care what people say about me. This is who I am. The good, the bad, the mess, the beauty, the joy. And I, for me, it's important, because that's what I have, and always thought that that's what should make me be ashamed of. And now I follow the saying, the privilege of life is being who you are. So take that again to say, the privilege of your life is to live for who you are meant to be. And as we look ahead, as I come to a close of my meant-to-be short talk, I am very much grateful for the journey we've shared together. As partners, sleeping and going to endless meetings. As participants in a workshop, we're meant to be facilitators, but we do become participants. And as family members, because of our stories have also touched our families. And every day we'll talk about how can I be better and how can my family be better. Thank you for that. Thank you for being the inspiration to each other. Thank you for being the challenge. Hey, you've been the challenge sometimes, right? And I've also been a challenge. No cell phones. No, Ostlio. No, my phone should be on. We've had those moments. And more than anything, we've been team players. For that, know that it is okay not to know what your next step looks like. And know that it's okay not to be okay. That's part of healing. But keep working hard towards the strength of your self-acceptance. And for that, I say, keep growing. Halala. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Cleo. That was beautiful and so authentic and from the heart. And so great to reflect a bit back. Thank you, Mampu, as well. It was good to look a little back so that we see how far we've come, right? And how far you've come so that we can look forward. So next up, I believe we have some storytelling, some testimonies, some story reading. Am I using the right jargon here? Book readings, right? So should I call them by name? Let me open the program. Bear with me 1 second. Okay, so that sound that you are hearing, it's a bird. He sees his own reflection and he's tapping on the window, okay? So it's not somebody from outside who's wanting to come in. But it's beautiful because it's a part of God's creation and it's so cute to see him doing that. Right, success stories, reading of transformational books. You see, if I consult the program, I will know what to say. And it's Ratlegile Matapelo and Tepiso. You are welcome to come to the front. Let's call them. So I just want to remind you, I know it feels awkward for each one of us. The cameras are here, so try to speak to the camera while you're telling your story to everybody else, because we're going to share the link with you. For those who joined late, there is a YouTube link that we can share with you. So before you leave, come get the link from us, okay? Or we can publish it. I'll ask my tech team, Tess, how to publish it for you. Or get it from Gladys or Gladys or Cleo, we'll share it with them. So we're going to encourage you to look at the camera, okay? There we go.
Okay. It's a real person behind the camera, so don't worry. Breathe and enjoy. You can
do
Okay, good day, ladies and gentlemen. I go by the name of Mathapelo Sehlo. Okay, the title of my book is Forgiveness is a Journey. I wrote this book hoping to get closure and be able to forgive. I hope it will become a shine by shedding light, hope, and comfort on the most difficult time I have experienced in my life. Chapter 1, Why Should I Forgive? One of the most powerful choices we can make as humans is to forgive those who have wronged us in some way. Forgiveness is a decision of letting go of the past. It doesn't mean that we have condoned what happened, but we simply mean that we have decided to move on from it. I remember when I was doing matric, it was an exciting moment for me. During that time, I was staying with my mom and my sister. That's when my sister decided to poison me in order to take my life. I almost died, but luckily I survived because God had other plans for me. I kept on asking myself many questions. Why would she try to kill me? What have I done wrong to her? I continued to focus on the pain experience and past. I felt angry and hurt. I felt powerless and victimized. For closure to occur, there has to be both forgiveness of other person and forgiveness of ourselves. Life is too short for us to worry about things we cannot change, things that have nothing for us but a potential to open old wounds. Whether you blame them for your hurt or not, but life goes on for them and yours is stuck in the past. Forgive myself for camping in the past. What happened in the past was meant to happen, and it was meant to take me where God wants me to be, and that is where I am not used to be. Forgiveness does not mean forgetting, but it means moving on, healed from the pain that has been put on us. Benefits of forgiving others frees us from anger. Forgiving is really not for other person's benefit, but is for our own. Forgiveness is a process. Sometimes your offenders will move on with their lives as though they have never done anything to you. But it is in such times like this that you need to let go of what is hurting you. We all have all done things in the past that we are not proud of. We have made mistakes. And if we are bid to be forgiven, therefore we need to forgive others and forgive ourselves as well. Without self-forgiveness, we continue to impose the emotional pain on ourselves and those around us. Forgiveness is a very important and powerful way to reclaim our power and find peace. Where there is forgiveness, there is peace. Chapter 2. I want to forgive, but I don't know how. Most of us sit with our feelings and wonder when forgiveness will happen. We think forgiveness only happens when the pain goes away, and it does not. Forgiveness does not happen because someone else knows they have wronged us. It happens because it is a choice. I am one of those people who say, I want to forgive, but I don't know how. I try every day to push the pain away. I try every day to ignore my feelings, but I cannot. This carries so much potential to dominate our lives and contaminate our soul if we let them. I need to realize that it is important and healthy to forgive, and forgiveness saves us from causing more pain to ourselves. I have a choice to forgive, even it means forgiving myself. Forgiveness frees our emotions and attentions to focus on what is in front of us, not to hold on what is in the past. Nothing good will come out of our ugly past, but more pain. Through forgiveness, we can get most from the future and move forward. There is nothing easy and fast about forgiveness. It is a process and also a journey. This journey with us making a decision to choose to forgive. Forgiving is letting go of the pain and anger. Starting by accepting and acknowledging where I am right now, and I cannot change what has been done to me. I won't focus my energy on what cannot be changed in my past. I will focus on how I will want to see my future unfolding for me. Forgive myself for the wrong choices I have made. Finding self-forgiveness is essential because it is the choice to regain peace of mind and love. It brings joy. I refuse to blame others for how I feel because I am the captain of my life. I am responsible for where I want to see my life. I am responsible for my happiness, and I am responsible for how I want to feel about a situation. I cannot tell my story in the future when I'm still holding on to the pain of the past, and when I'm still blaming other people for what I am only can change. The pain can last a month, a year, and even a decade. I need to understand that when I am holding on to a negative thought, I am hating myself. Things will not always and never go our way at all time. The importance of letting go and forgiving is that it helps us to lose the negative side of the harm and expose us to the positive side. Chapter 3, refuse to stop trying. Pain can change a person. It will affect your self-image and how you perceive yourself. There are times when I feel like I don't deserve better. I will feel like I'm a loser. But one way to go on is to refuse to stop trying to be better. No matter how I have felt in the past, I can move on and become a better person. I once tried to solve a problem with my family. First, I wanted to know what is the problem is, and I refused to remain silent about all the conflict around my family. I was doing it for the sake of peace, but it got interrupted by chaos. As I know what is threatening my peace, I gather enough courage to face it. I don't avoid the fact that it is troubling me. Letting go of the past is the only way to move forward. I need to stop worrying and also stop wondering what if. I need to realize that everything in life happens for a reason. chapter 4, letting go. By forgiving those who have hurt us, we give our mind a certification and peace it needs. It helps us to discover a new state of mind, even though it does not remove the past, but it gives us a positive energy that may create a better future. Forgiving doesn't mean forgetting, but it means moving on healed from the past that has hurt us in some way. And this can happen when you allow yourself to cry and seek help. Forgiveness means you have made peace with the pain, and I am ready to let it go so I can move forward in life. Not for someone else, but for me. This allows me to become a strong person by facing my pain, forgiving and releasing it. Forgiving is not always about others. It's more about forgiving myself. We feel guilty for the wrongdoings done to us, thinking we are the reason for that to happen. The truth is, guilt never makes anyone feel better. When I forgive myself, I realize it is me who needs it more than I need to love myself, and I need to love myself more. I realize that forgiving someone is the highest and most beautiful form of love. Chapter 5, finding my shape. The person I have become today has been shaped by the experiences of my past, which were beyond my control. I believe everything in life happens for a reason. The pain I went through was meant to shape and prepare me for my purpose. I may not have liked the process, but I'm certain it was the benefit of those who are coming after me. No matter how long I have held on the negative thought, or how much I have suffered emotionally because of someone else, failing to take responsibility of my life gives another person the power to control and shape my life. To find my shape, I need to take charge of my life, forgive myself and my offenders. My mother used to encourage me to be positive on my thinking about myself and about the situation which were beyond my control. It's now that I get to understand why she was encouraging me. Anger will make you say or do things you wouldn't do in your normal state of mind. The way I experience my past affects my present thoughts, feelings, and actions. The end.
The title of my book is At the End of the Tunnel, There is Always a Light. Losing yourself, happiness, and inner peace is very easy, but finding yourself is very difficult. Finding yourself is a journey that is full of fear and doubt. The journey that you have to take in order for you to find yourself requires bravery, honesty, and self-reflection. It's time to put your fear aside and embrace the reality. Face the challenge that you encounter in your life, because hiding from your problems won't help you. It will only destroy your peace and happiness. Take each day as it comes with an open heart and positive mindset. Keep your head held high, your spirit shining bright. Don't give up. Gather all your courage and fight. You deserve to be free and have no baggage in your heart. Embrace the beauty of the unknown. Chapter 1, Betrayal. It's hard being betrayed by your close people. It's hard a lot not to feel safe and comfortable around people. People out there got nothing but pure intention, but it's hard to believe that because I have been betrayed and brokenhearted before. I'm not able to talk to people not because I don't want, but because I'm scared. I'm scared to be betrayed again. The saddest thing about the betrayal is that it never comes from your enemies. It comes from those you trust the most, hence sometimes I act rudely. I tend to push people away because I don't want them to get too close or too friendly. I've suffered enough, and that's why I do this wrong thing of being cold and rude to people. You know, it's kind of funny how they act after they had betrayed me. They act like victims. They blackmail me emotionally. They don't feel bad or show remorse. Instead, they want me to take the blame. Never think that you know a person because they are very good at pretending. Life is full of fake people, right? But I believe that sometimes you have to be tricked and misled by the wrong people once or twice in your life in order to find and appreciate the right one when they arrive. Dear cousin, best friend, and new close friend, I'm glad that you betrayed me and decided to get out of my life because your betrayal had made me and my blood sister very close. We weren't close, but right now I'm proud enough to say we have that sisterhood relationship that I had been yearning for all along. I used to take betrayal by heart, but I don't want that anymore because I don't want to hold grudges. I got a sharp tongue. That's why I want to stop wishing bad things happen to those who hurt me. After all, wishes do come true. I want to get rid of this cold heart and rudeness because it brings nothing but hatred. I don't want to seek revenge anymore. Instead, I want karma to deal with them. I don't want to blame myself after being betrayed. Yes, betrayal hurts. But from now on, I will just smile and be glad that you betrayed me. Anyway, everything happens for a reason. I will always leave a room for disappointment and choosing my circle of friends wisely. Thank you to those who betrayed me because you had made me more careful. Today, I choose not to stay down and feel pity for myself for being betrayed. Instead, I will get up and keep moving forward because I want to be better, not bitter. I'm a warrior who will continue to rise again. Never let the same snake bite you twice. Judgmental. Oh, where do I start about this judgmental issue? Anyway, I'll start from the beginning. Okay, firstly, I want to forgive my brother for judging me about my sexuality. I know that you have never heard about this LGBTQ, and you never imagined one of your sisters being part of it. I forgive you even though what you did destroyed me and my happiness. I do understand that you were concerned about how will I survive in the future. Abudi, can you please let go of that mentality of yours? You need a man in your life, and a man must be the one who provides for his own family. This is new generation, and that line does not exist anymore. It's 50-50 now. I dropped a bombshell at you without even explaining, and I'm sorry for that, but you had no right to judge me or made me choose between you and my own sexuality. You have made things very difficult for me back there when we said I must choose between being part of your life and being part of the LGBTQI. And guess what? I have chosen you, and that was the very stupid thing I've ever done in my entire life. That's cruelty, big bro. You never thought about how I'm going to feel. Anyway, that's water under the bridge. I make a commitment to that I will always choose myself over everything or everyone, even if I have to lose few people along the way. People's opinion, oh, darling, they will never ever matter anymore. People will always talk, but from now on, I won't mind them. Let their negativity or opinion affect me or destroy me. I will never try to change who I am just because I want to fit in. I'll rather be alone than being with people who want to destroy my happiness. Accept who I am and my lifestyle, or leave me alone. I will always follow my heart, even if in the process it will hurt others. Oh, remember that I'm not saying I don't care about others' feelings, but at the end of the day, we have to understand that our happiness matters the most. Choose yourself every time to avoid living in regret. You know it's time to live my life the way I want. Take a judgment as a way to make you strong each and every day. I will never mind to be judged for doing things that bring peace in me, or being who I am. After all, being judged is part of life. I know why I have chosen this lifestyle, so I will never let people to manipulate me or
that I'm not good enough just because I live different life from theirs. I know what's good and bad for me. I will never hide anymore just because I'm scared at being judged or being treated differently. Starting from today, I will embrace myself, my sexuality. It's time to put myself, value myself more, and to know that I'm worth everything. I will love myself more and my sexuality. Hashtag embrace the real you. Expression. Expressing how I feel is very difficult for me. Most of us are facing anxiety and depression and having anger issue and end up committing suicide. We can't express our feelings because we live in a society or family of late generations whereby they believe that whenever their kids raise some few points about how they feel, it's being called disrespectful. We're going through a lot, but our parents seem not to care. You know, our parents have that mentality of only white people are the one who can see psychologists or attend therapy. They believe that everything that happens in this life is because of witchcraft, and they are totally wrong, because some things need medical attention only. Last year, I was going through a lot. Even now, I'm still going through a lot. And you won't believe me when I say no one cared to ask how I'm coping, and they swear that I was not doing good at all. I was drained emotional and end up having social thoughts, but they never came. I fought my matric right, and guess what? My family said, Nana, you are still young. You can read again, and besides that, we all know the reason why you fall, so don't feel bad, okay? Yes, they knew the reason why I failed, but again, they wanted me to go and reread without even trying to find help for me. They failed to be emotionally there for me again. Instead, they said I must relocate because according to them, that place was very toxic for me. You know what's hurt the most? My sister saw that I was crying every night. She saw the pain and fear in my eyes, the anger. She saw that I was losing weight, but she left me all alone. She used to make me feel like I'm not normal when I tried to explain what I felt deep inside me. Is this trauma or what? But anyway, this caused me to keep things to myself, and I want that to stop because I can't handle the pain anymore. I'm very tired about the fake smile that I put on my face each and every day. Tired of screaming and crying all alone. From now on, I want to be able to write about my feelings. Acknowledge my feelings because sometimes I tend to be too sad or too happy for no reason, and that bothers me. I will always ask empathy from others and from the men above us. Be able to respond my feelings in a healthy way. I will no longer control by my emotions and I won't repress my feelings anymore. I want to express my feelings in a calm way and to think before I speak to avoid things that I don't want to say. Talk about how I feel without being asked. Express my feelings at my own time without being forced. I want to be able to over-explain and then remain quiet to avoid conflict or misunderstanding. I don't want to fake my happiness and to pretend like I'm okay while I'm not. After all, in order for a person to feel deeply happy, he or she must also be able to feel deeply sad. We do not get to choose one or the other. I want to let people in and be there for me in times of drama and sorrow. I swear on my grandfather's grave that my brother's children and my sister's child won't suffer emotionally in my presence. Your mind, feelings, and mental health truly matters. Appreciation. Appreciation. That's what I can do. You know, I have that tendency of making people that they are not trying enough. I take their effort very slightly, and I have noticed that some of them feel very useless when I don't appreciate little things that they do for me. Today, I want that to stop. I want to learn how to appreciate people's effort and presence in my life. I want to be grateful for little that happened in my life. Appreciate little things that I have achieved so far. Be grateful that I'm still alive and kicking. I want to be able to appreciate without complaining. First, or feel like that person who have helped me will say, if it wasn't me, you will never have been here today. I want to say thank you without feeling like I've committed a sin. Saying thank you is very difficult for me, but I'm willing to say it at any cost. I don't value my life, and never did. That's why I never appreciate that I'm still alive. I keep on creating a picture about how my funeral will be. Will my death affect others? That's the question I ask myself each and every day. My mother is a hustler, and sometimes I feel like she is a single mother, but you won't believe me when I say I feel like she is not parenting me good enough. She is trying very hard, but I keep on making her feel like she is not a good parent. It is very hard for me to appreciate her effort, love, caring, but from now on, I want to appreciate her before it's too late. Yes, she is not there for me emotionally, but she supports me financially. I'm that person who wants to be appreciated, but I fail to do the same, and that bothers me now. I want people to worship the ground that I work in, but I can't do that. I want to stop thinking that the world revolves around me. This one is for myself. Dear Sihle, you have been through a lot, Nana, and you deserve a cup for not giving up. You are a true definition of a strong girl. You endured so much, but you stood your ground. I thank you for moving forward and for showing strength and courage. I know you disappointed yourself so much, and I know you are trying your best, but it all ends up in a failure. But one thing I love about you is that you never give up. Yes, sometimes you feel like God don't love you or he has his own favorite kids, but then again, you remember that it is not your time to shine. Yours will come. I'm proud of you, Mbopinyan. And I'm pretty sure we will arrive at some point to what we dreamed of. Keep on dreaming big. Your time to shine will come. Life is not easy at all. Sometimes you cry, hurt more than you can bear, get so tired, but you keep on moving forward despite all the pain that you feel. Thank you for being patient, even though sometimes I treated you badly. I love you and always do. I'll always love you, Nana. I'm dedicating Loving Me by Janet to you all. Thank you.
Hi everyone, am I audible? Langkutla? Okay. Hi everyone. Hi. My name is Tepone, Tepo Makhasi, and the name of my book is Letters of Affirmation to Myself. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right? So, of course, I'm the author and I'm the editor. Wow. And one thing about my book, it's not really a book as such, but it's more of a memoir, you know? Yeah, hence I chose the heading Letters of Affirmation to Myself. Okay, chapter one, do not give up. Okay. Dear me, you gave so much importance to the things and people around you. Even small things really affect you because you are sentimental and caring. You get upset for things you prayed for because they don't go the way you wanted to, however they go the way they should be. You can't control your emotions. You let your anger ruin your good personality. And no matter how short life is, you still wake up in the morning with regrets. Truth is, you're not perfect. But one thing I'm certain about is you love the people around you and forgive those who wronged you because you believe that everything happens for a reason. So if you get a chance, take it. If it changes your life, let it. Because really, no one said it would be easy, just that it would be worth it. Love me. Chapter 2. Dear me, you're confident and ambitious, but don't let your pride blind you. You're creative and determined. You can achieve everything if you put your best into it. If you did your best and nothing happened, give up. But before you give up this time, ask yourself this question. Did you really do your best? Life is too short for indecisions and vacillations. Do every good thing that makes you happy and find happiness in the things that are temporary. Keep up the good work and seize the day. The Lord will guide you into the right path. Love me. Chapter 3. The sky is not always blue, and that's okay. Dear me, up until now, you're still keeping the wounds in your heart, the wounds that were caused by your family and the memory of your past. God knows how you wanted to be loved and understood by others. He's willing to give you peace and rest. I know that it's not easy, but you need to move on. When God closed that door of opportunity, he opened another door for you. So don't let your eyes be fixed upon the closed door to the point where you no longer notice the blessings he has for you. You deserve peace and healing. Let the burden go. Love me. Chapter 4, A New Season, Spring. Dear me, you're hungry for growth and you're eager to learn, but comparing your progress to someone else's will never let you feel satisfied and contented. I know you want to be successful, and I admire how you see your future full of beautiful plans with good determination. But don't let your heart be filled with pride. You're intelligent and passionate, so don't let your emotions be the decision maker. You are loved and appreciated by me, of course. Guard your heart and humble yourself before God. Your season is coming. Stay faithful. Chapter 5, and the final chapter, is called The Beginning of an Era. Dear me, you have a deep desire to grow and change. You can achieve your goal when you go out of your comfort zone. You are optimistic and realistic and idealistic. You live by principles. Always remember that not all those who are fun to be with are good to be with. Find someone who will help you grow and be more open to good advice that will help you build a good you. Trust in the Lord in everything you do, and your plans will succeed. And for what it's worth, I love you, baby girl. Thank you.
There comes a time when we hit a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There dying. Oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We can't go on pretending day by day
that someone somehow will soon make a change.
We are all a part of God's great big family. True. You know, love is all we need. We are the ones. We are the children. We are the ones who make the world a day when students are given. There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's true, we'll make a better day. Just you and me.
Their cries for help will not be in vain.
We can't let them suffer. No, we cannot turn away.
Right now, they need a helping hand.
No, someone lie. We are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start giving.
Stuck in there.
we make it. We're saving our own lives. It's just you and make a better day. Just you and me.
Wow, sure, that was awesome. Thank you for putting that together, ladies. That's a phenomenal job. And thank you for sharing your books, your transformation, and being so vulnerable with us. Thank you. And now, the moment we've been waiting for. Okay, are you ready? I'd like to invite our panel to the front. You've prepared the certificates. We have our delegates, hopefully in alphabetical order. So without further ado, over to Cleo and Gladys and Mampu. The stage is yours.
Pretty and beautiful and handsome.
Okay, can I steal your shine? Photographs are not here, so we thought we'll take with your phones. So because there's a precision, so whoever's going to take your picture, can they be ready? Ne? Cool.
All right, so you're done. All right, so the time has come where we are saying you have done it. As difficult as you thought it was in the beginning, but you did it. So this is the certificate of participation for attending a 5 days Creators of Peace Circle workshop on inner healing, exploring character building, moral values, conflict resolution, communication skills, decision-making skills, planning skills, power of forgiveness, anger management, inner peace, and trust-building techniques. So this is all that you have done, and I'm proud of you because you have done it. So the first participant is Donald Maki. Yay! Yes, Donald. Donald. Look at the camera. Tapelo Linaba. Yay. Joy Kolonyane. Tepo Mahasi. Yeah? Oh, no. You did it. She asked for it, and she deserves it. Masilaelo Mahela. Mpo gift. Mpo gift. Makura. Is he here? Ablonia Malemani. Michelle Malete. Matapelo Mamabulo. Woo! Woo! Yo, what night in? Blessing Maswangani. Dipuwa Matlakala. Boitumelo Motsepe. Woo! Hey! Kolani Matsika. Sizani Magwenya.
She's absent.
Akrineth Nsanga. Woo! Yay!
You're welcome.
Abele. Karabo Muhukari. She's not here. No, Kumukwena. Woo! Yay, 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 yay! Lebohang Malom. Lebohang, are you coming? Dimpo Mpakani. Woo! Yay! You did it. Josephine Nkwana. Yeah. Lebogang Molomo. Caroline Palani. Dimpho Ragalakane. What happened? Betty Ramasobana, our singer. Pindile Ratlalani. Betty's coming first. Pindile Ratlalani. Yay! Pindile. Welcome. Rida Sambo. Tukelo Slape.
Hiyo. Hey, how about you?
Priscilla Sruwe. Maggie Sisotoma. Ireshni Sefil.
Yes, when I can.
You're welcome.
Lerato Setswanto. Lindi Welegane re atlegile mabuitshege mpopinyana mpopinyana ya papage Thomas Magai. He said somebody will take it for him. Lesedi Mukitla. Destiny Maphosa. Koketso Maseko. Mavis Matib. Tepiso Mlalakot. This one again. Wesley Chabalal. Hey, this one again. Khomotso Mnari Refile Ntswane Siwalindile Nyati Mathapelo Sehlohu. Okay. Mohadi Sekgala. Rachel Sekoba. Woo! As Rachel! Hey! Hey! Sipiwe Sibanyoni. Nomhle. Mpho Mashala. Woo! Yes, when I yell. There's an error, but we fix it. Did you all receive your certificates? Who shot up, Oma? Dipuo. Dipuo to Akai. Ke dipuo fela. Dipuo matlakala. Did I call all of you? Oh, okay, congratulations. Yay!
Well done, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you to our panel with such a beautiful ceremony. Did you enjoy that? You looked fabulous. So we are almost done, but not yet. Okay, so I want to call on Wesley to come back. She looks so surprised, but she's dressed to the T for this moment as well. Not just for the certificate. So you're welcome to come up front, young lady. Or if you want to put the phone in, we can do that. Okay, you can stand.
Hello, everyone. I go by the name of Wesley Chabalala-Nontandla. I'm here to do a Thanksgiving speech to ODA ne Ukulunga Foundation. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, and esteemed professors, fellow graduates, and honored guests, today as we gather to celebrate our graduation, I stand before you as a proud graduate in both the fields of computer science and e-learning through counseling. It is an honor to share with you the profound impact that my tutors and lecturers have had on my journey to this momentous day. Throughout our educational journey, our mentors play a pivotal role in shaping our perspectives and nurturing our potential. My tutors and lecturers in the field of counseling have been nothing short of extraordinary. They have not only impacted knowledge, but also instilled in me a deeper understanding of the human experience and invaluable skill of offering support and guidance to those in need. Counseling is a profession that touches lives in profound ways. It equips us with the tool to address the challenges and complexities an individual's face in their lives. Through their unwavering dedication, my teachers and lecturers have shown me the importance of empathy, active listening, and the power of human connection. They have demonstrated that a compassionate ear and a caring heart can provide solace and healing to those who are struggling. As I reflect on my journey, I am reminded of the countless hours my mentors spent with me, sharing their wisdom, experience, and insights. They created a nurturing environment where I could grow not only as a student, but as a compassionate and empathic individual. Their guidance extended far beyond the classroom as they encouraged me to explore the depth of my own self-awareness and understanding. I must also acknowledge the importance of the computer science program in my life. The world of technology is ever evolving, and computer science professors have equipped me with the skills and knowledge needed to thrive in this dynamic field. Their commitment to excellence and their ability to convey complex concepts in a comprehensively manner have been instrumental in my academic success. In conclusion, today's achievement is a testament to the dedicated and guidance of my teachers and lecturers. They have instilled in me the belief that through counseling, we can make a profound impact on the lives of others. Their commitment to education and mentorship has not only shaped my academic journey, but has also ignited a passive within me to contribute positive to society. As we move forward into the world, let us carry the lesson learned from our mentors with us. Let us continue to be passionate listeners, eager learners, and for change. I am deeply grateful for the invaluable contribution of my tutors and lecturers to my journey, and I know that their teachings will continue to inspire and guide me in the chapters lie ahead. Thank you, and congratulations to my fellow graduates. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Wesley. And now I believe it's the turn of Vanessa, Kulisa, and Joseph, who's going to entertain us. Are you ready?
Yay.
Afternoon. I was supposed to perform African Genius-ish, so I couldn't send my track in time, so we're let's just go for a cappella. Then I want you to sing along, and chorus go like this. I'm not good in singing, so I want you to assist me when it comes to singing. I'm going to rap. And okay. I just met beautiful girl. 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 I just met some guy. 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 Where to start is hard to tell. I want to take you when we met. So pity good one can be met. Story of a band you've been had. Oh, this one can be catch. My heartbeat is what I felt. I'm Chris, I just want to chat. I'm trying to pay a compliment. You are beautiful, it's not a lie. Believe me, it's not a lie. Nature call, I'm starting to get high. Catching a feeling I can fly. Want to kiss her, my lips have been dry. I just met beautiful girl. 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 I just met some guy. 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 Thank you.
I'm not sure I can follow that act now, you know. Thank you so much. I know it's also a brave act to share your creativity, but I love your responsiveness, and thank you for sharing. So I'm just checking on my list. I know I've got poetry from Mpo, Mashallah, right? And I don't know if it's with Tapela or whether you guys are separate. So you guys can, you're welcome to come grace us with your presence and share your item with us.
Hey guys, I never met a beautiful girl, but I met adorable women and mothers in this place, I can say. And thank you for the sister with the worship and for descending the spirit of the Lord amongst this place, guys. It's a very nice thing. So I have recited a 2 seconds poem for you guys. It goes like this. Ukulunga kuyisifundiso esihle emphakathini. Kunothando nobuntu esikhathini. Happiness initiates peace within. If you must look back, do so forgivingly. If you must look forward, do so prayerfully. Life isn't always sunshine and butterflies. Sometimes you have to learn to smile through the pain for you to gain. The best feeling is when someone appreciates everything about you that someone else took for granted. It was a blessing to heal without any medicine. The feeling was real, you know what I mean. When your inner self is free, you can finally believe, to live and to dream, whatever is rare. Without any fear, you can really be here. If you can only declare, the rest can be there. Although it ain't fair, always be grateful for what is near. Love will always be close to the brokenhearted. Without any cost, it can never be departed. For the journey will always be imparted, but inside you is the courage to win and to always live according to his will. Thank you, guys.
Dumela. Dumela. Kimpo. My poet goes by the name Umhlaba uyahlaba. Umhlaba uyahlaba. Kunzima emhlabeni. Angihleki. Angihleki ngoba ngijabule ngihleka ngihlekiswa ubuhlungu engibuzwa ngaphakathi kimi. Angihleki ngoba ngijabule ngihlekiswa ukuthi inhliziyo yami igobhoza igazi. Umhlaba uyahlaba. Kunzima emhlabeni. Uhlabe bani mhlaba ungenazandla na? Uhlabe bani mhlaba ungaphathanga izikhali? Yet umhlaba uyahlaba. Kunzima emhlabeni. Angihlatshwanga umhlaba mina, ngihlatshwe izenzo zomuntu zobubi bakhe. Angihlatshwanga umhlaba mina, ngihlatshwa amagama akuphimiselwe umuntu aphume emlomeni wakhe amabi. Angihlatshwanga umhlaba mina, ngihlatshwe izenzo esizenzako thina, senzana thina sisodwa. Angihleki. Angihleki. Ngihlekiswa ubuhlungu engibuzwa ngaphakathi enhlizweni yami. Ngihlekiswa kungendlela senza izinto ngakhona. Ngimangazwa kungendlela sithatha izinto ezingaphili sizenza ziphile. Ngenxa yokufuna ukujustifya ubuhlungu esibenza kwabanye abantu. Ngihlekiswa kungendlela ukuthi sizothi umhlaba uyaphila ungaphathanga sikhali. Wena ophethe isikhali hayi umhlaba. Sibuzwile ubuhlungu isitho sami sangasese. Sibuzwile ubuhlungu isitho sami sangasese. Sibuzwile ubuhlungu baziphinda-phinda ubuhlungu baze baphenduka injwayelo. Sibuzwile ubuhlungu baphinda-phinda ngaze ngacabanga ukuthi kungendlela esiphila ngakhona kulo mhlaba. Sibuzwile ubuhlungu isitho sami sangasese. Baziphinda-phinda ubuhlungu. Umhlaba uyahlaba. Kunzima emhlabeni. Yini enzima ngomhlaba na? Yini enzima emhlabeni? Kunzima yini ukuthanda umntwana kamakhelwane njengoba uthanda ebakho abantwana? Kunzima yini ukuhlonipha umntwana kamakhelwane njengoba ufuna ukuhlonitshwa wena? Kunzima yini ukuhlonipha wonke umuntu osifazane okhona emhlabeni njengoba udeserve ukuhlonipha umama wakho? Kunzima yini ukuhlonipha wonke umuntu osifazane emhlabeni njengoba ufuna nawe uhlonitshwe? Ubuhlungu baze baphenduka injwayelo. Baziphinda-phinda ubuhlungu uyakhala intombazana yathi ma. Ma, kwathiwa thula, umdlalo lona. Thula, uzothola amaswiti. Thula, wangathuli uzofa. Umdlalo onjani ekungamelanga ngitshele uma ngawo? Umdlalo onjani ekungamelanga ngitshele muntu ngawo? Umdlalo onjani ozongibulala? Umhlaba uyahlaba. Kunzima emhlabeni. Sibuzwile ubuhlungu isitho sangasese, intombazanyana encane yakhala yathi ma. Ma, ngibuzwile ubuhlungu. Ma, ngibuzwile ubuhlungu. Ubaba ungilimazile. Ngibuzwile ubuhlungu, malume ungilimazile. Ngibuzwile ubuhlungu, ubhuti ungilimazile. Kwathiwa shh. Thula ngane yami. Thula ngane yami. Thula ngane yami. Kuzothiwani uma abomakhelwane bangezwa le ndaba? Kuzothiwani uma ubaba wakho angaboshwa sodlani? Thula ngane yami. Thula ngane yami. kuzothiwani uma ubhuti wakho angaboshwa ngokwenza imfundo zakhe zobudokotela. Isasa lakhe lizabe likuphi uma angaboshwa ubhuti wakho mntanami? Isithunzi somndeni, isasa lakhe omakhelwane sodlane. Kunzima emhlabeni. Angihleki ngoba ngijabule, ngihlekisa ubuhlungu obugobhoza ngaphakathi enhlizweni yami. Isithunzi somndeni, isasa lomakhelwane sodlane. Kuthiwani ngesasa lentombazanyane encane na? Kuthiwani ngesithunzi sakhe, isidima sakhe na? Kuthiwani ngezinto ezifunwa uyena na? Kuthiwani ngobuhlungu yena abuzuyile ngaphakathi kuyena na? Isithunzi somndeni, isasa lomakhelwane sodlane. Lalelake. Kuzothiwani uma le ntombazanyana kusasa ingathandana nabo baba abadala? Kuzothiwani kusasa le ntombazanyana uma ingavuka izibulele? Kuzothiwani mhlazana akhula ahlangabezana nobunzima obuzabe bukhona ngaphakathi kuye, i-trauma nokuhlangahlangana empilweni yakhe? Bazabe bakuphi omakhelwane? Sizabe sikuphi isithunzi somndeni ngaleso sikhathi? Kuzabe kwenzakaleni ngaye? Umhlaba uyahlaba. Kunzima emhlabeni. Asibhekeni i-community esifuna ukuphila ngaphakathi kuyona. Asibhekeni izinto thina esizenza kwabanye. Asibhekeni isasa le-community yethu. Umhlaba uyahlaba. Kunzima emhlabeni. Ngithanda ukubonga mina ngoba ngikwazile ukuthola ikhaya. Ngikwazile ukuthola ikhaya ku-ODA. I-ODA yangikhuphula, yangitholisa elinye ikhaya futhi. Kukulunga. Sesihliyo, sesigledisi. Ngibonga konke enisenzele kona. May God bless you and your families for everything that you have done for us. Ngiyabonga. Viva! Viva nge-ODA, viva.
Viva!
Viva ngokokulunga, viva.
Viva!
Phansi nge-GPV, phansi!
Phansi
nge-GPV, phansi!
It feels like I need to let that sink in. So, Simpiwe is our next entertainer. I was looking for the right word. But I do want to check with Simpiwe if the space is good. I don't know if I may say that it's a modeling item, so hence my question. So, piano in the way, is it okay? Is she here, or is she outside, or is she here, or not here? Okay, sorry then. So then, no, not doing it. Bad idea. Okay, so Cleo and Gladys and Mampu just checking the program. Is there anyone else on the list? The dance, right? Please come. The stage is yours. I'm sorry that I cleared the stage. Woo! That was so good. We are almost done, and I can imagine you are now thirsty and hungry. But I do want this on video so that you can look back at it. We'd like to give you a gift from Ukulunga Foundation. You will see there's a sticker on it. Ukulunga Foundation. And the analogy of the plant, I'm sure you're familiar with it, is because you've gone through it during the workshop, is that you learn to garden and nurture and take care of yourself, your inner body, your soul, like you do a plant, right? You do gardening of your soul. We acknowledge, especially in the church, I don't know what's your faith and religion, but if you believe in Jesus and God, we believe you are body, soul, and spirit. So even if this is an analogy to take care of your soul, we'd like you to feed your mind, your spirit, your intellect, your emotions, your finances, everything that makes you you. So this is something to take with you, to nurture this, to grow it, to take care of it like you would yourself. Sometimes the flowers will die, but this plant is evergreen. It should not die. But water it, feed it, take care of it like you should yourself. And may you always remember what you've learned through these workshops and how far you've come. But remember, this is one plant in a small pot. Just imagine how big a farm, a forest, a world it can grow if you let it. So thank you and God bless. And come and enjoy some refreshments with us. Thank you. Thank you. So outside, you'll see there's tea and coffee. Please help yourselves, okay? And then we've got some cold drinks, and I've got a beautiful lady, Mpo. She makes what? How do you say mangwenya? Mangwenya, fat cakes for us for today. Mangwenya. I thought I was wrong, but thank you, mangwenya, that one. And she worked in the kitchen all this time to bless us. And you're welcome to join us then there at the back. The plants are there. We just left them there because we know. You know, you've got a shoe and a bag and a hat and a cell phone. So, but when you leave, okay, and you get on the bus, take a plant. Pick one for you. Okay, God bless you.